Look, let's turn to the RBA now, because it seems that Albanese is not just failing on the international stage, but he's doing the same with economic management. Bronwyn Bishop, we are seeing concerns, this is from the RBA's last board minutes, that the outlook just isn't looking rosy.
Well, it isn't, Sharri. The fact of the matter is the problem remains what it's been all along. The RBA only has one tool, and that is interest rates. And it's a blunt instrument. But the government has fiscal policy, and it has done nothing to rein in its expenditure. It has added to expenditure, which has kept the pressure up. It has created jobs that are government paid for jobs. So there's no productivity happening in the economy. So what we're seeing is the Reserve Bank just being honest. Until the government does, in fact, rein in its expenditure, rein in the things that are still keeping inflation high, then you can't expect the Reserve Bank to lower those interest rates. And it's hurting. And it's hurting businesses. And it's hurting people who are the real generators of wealth in this country, the private sector. Whereas all they're interested in is the unions and the public sector. They have no care whatsoever for really making a remedy that can be, in fact, helping people get back on their feet. So they just blame supermarkets, they blame the Reserve Bank. It's all everybody else's fault. It's never their fault. Until they take responsibility, or until they're made to, or chucked out simply as the government, we won't get back to sensible policies.
All right. Look, we're actually out of time. Caleb Bond, I'll get to you next Tuesday when I'm back in Australia. Thank you both for your time this evening.